dear students, and welcome back in our video lecture with the same topic, periodic classification of elements. In my previous video lecture, we have discussed about atomic mass, atomic number, and the first scientist who just tried to classify all the elements which were present at that time, Doberiner. So we have studied about Doberiner triads. Now we are going to study one more scientist and his law, that is Newland's law of octave. After Doberiner, in 1664, you can see here, Newland was a scientist who tried to classify all the elements which were present at the time. So what is Newland's law? When elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic masses, the properties of the 8th element are similar to that of 1st element. So you can see here, students, as like Doberiner, Newland's law is also based on atomic masses. In my previous video lecture, I told you about atomic mass and atomic number. Means what is mean by atomic mass and what is mean by atomic number. Doberiner's law was also based on atomic mass, and this Newland's law is also based on atomic mass. So what is Newland's law? When elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic masses, then property of the 8th element are similar to the properties of 1st element. You can see here. I will explain with example. Hydrogen, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, then fluorine, sodium, magnesium, aluminium. You can see here many elements are there, and they are just arranged in the increasing order of their atomic masses. When we just tally this Newland's law with example, when we are talking about hydrogen, if we take hydrogen as first element, then after hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Fluorine was the 8th element. So properties of hydrogen and properties of fluorine are same. Then when we take example of lithium, then from when we consider lithium as first element, then from lithium 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, sodium was the 8th element. You can see here, when we start with lithium, then sodium is the 8th element. Then properties of lithium and sodium are same. If we start with sodium as first element, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8th element is potassium. Then properties of sodium and properties of potassium are similar. But we can see here, properties of lithium, sodium and potassium, all properties are same. They all have same chemical properties. So this is Newland's law. It is very easy. What is Newland's law? When elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic masses, then the properties of every 8th element are similar to that of 1st element. So you can see here, you can explain this law by taking any example, hydrogen, fluorine, lithium, sodium or sodium, potassium. You can explain it by taking any example. Then what are the limitations of Newland's law? Why nowadays we are not using this Newland's law? Because Newland was the scientist who successfully classified that elements in his periodic table, but certain limitations are there. First limitation was, Newland could classify only up to calcium. So students, at the time of Newland, total 56 elements were present at that time, but out of those 56 elements, Newland could classify only up to calcium. After that, every 8th element didn't possess the property of 1st element. Here Newland's law failed. Second limitation, only 56 elements were present, and Newland's means he couldn't arrange any further arrangement in his table for the elements which we'll discover later. That's why we are not using Newland's table, Newland's periodic table, Newland's law nowadays. And then next limitation was to make this, while making this table, while making this chart, Newland arranged one or two means more elements in the same slot. That's why cobalt and nickel were put in same group, which have different properties. Means after calcium, other elements did not obey Newland's law. These are the limitations of Newland's law. So I will again explain. Newland was the scientist who just in 1864 arranged all elements in increasing order of their atomic masses. Then he just found that the properties of 8th element are similar to that of 1st element. So in this chart, when we just start with hydrogen, then hydrogen and fluorine has similar property. When we start with lithium, then lithium and sodium has similar property like this. We can continue. Then what are the limitations? Newland group at the time of Newland, 56 elements were present, but out of these 56 elements, Newland could classify only up to calcium. After calcium, these elements which were present at that time did not obey Newland's law. Then after, in some places like cobalt and nickel is the limit. This is the limitation of Newland's law. Why? Because cobalt and nickel, he just put them in same group, but cobalt and nickel have totally different properties. So these are the limitations of Newland's law. That's why we are not using this Newland's law nowadays. Then after Newland's, Mendeleev was the scientist who just tried to classify elements which were present at that time. So students, we have studied about Dobereiner's triad, and also we have studied about Newland's law of octave. So next we will study what is Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, now we are going to study about Mendeleev's periodic table. So Mendeleev's periodic table, before we discuss Mendeleev's periodic table, students, you should know some terms related to Mendeleev's periodic table, and also in a modern periodic table we will use these terms. So you should know this term. First term is periodic table. What is mean by periodic table? The periodic table is chart of elements prepared in such a way that elements having similar properties occurs in same vertical columns or groups. What is mean by periodic table? Periodic table is nothing but a chart of elements in which elements are just arranged according to their similarities, similar properties, so that they will come in same column, same group. Then in Mendeleev's periodic table, two more terms are there, periods and groups. Then what is mean by periods? Periods means horizontal rows like this. And what is mean by groups? Groups are vertical columns like this. So periods are horizontal rows, and groups means nothing but vertical columns. Vertical columns and horizontal rows. So now, as like Dobereiner and Newland, Mendeleev's periodic table is also based on atomic mass number and not on atomic number. So as like this Dobereiner triad and Newland's octave, this Mendeleev's periodic table is also based on atomic masses of element, and also it depends upon physical and chemical properties of the elements which were present at that time. Means Mendeleev also concentrated on atomic masses and physical and chemical properties of elements. One more thing that Mendeleev just mentioned in his periodic table, he just concentrated on physicochemical properties. So on which chemical properties Mendeleev concentrated more? He just concentrated on the chemical property of compound formed by the elements with oxygen and hydrogen, because hydrogen and oxygen are the most reactive atoms with any other element. That's why he just concentrated on the reaction with oxygen and hydrogen. Then when we are talking about Mendeleev's periodic table, this Mendeleev's periodic table consists of 7 periods, means 7 horizontal lines are there, horizontal rows are there, and 8 groups, means 8 vertical columns, 8 vertical lines are there in Mendeleev's periodic table. So what I said, Mendeleev's periodic table consists of how many periods? 7 periods. And how many groups? 8 groups are there. Out of these 8 groups, first to 7th group consist of normal elements, and 8th group consist of all transition elements which were present at that time. Got it, students? So out of these 8 groups, first 7th columns, 7th group consists of normal elements, and 8th group is of transition elements. And as we all know, noble gases were not discovered at that time, so in his periodic table noble gases were absent. So this is about the nature of Mendeleev periodic table. Again I repeat, what is Mendeleev's periodic table? Mendeleev's periodic table is based on atomic masses and physical and chemical properties of elements. Also it consists of these 7 periods and 8 groups. Out of these 8 groups, first 7 are normal elements, and 8th group consists of all transition elements. Then what is exactly Mendeleev's periodic law? So Mendeleev's periodic law states that the properties of elements are the periodic function of their atomic mass, means it is related to atomic mass only. Then what is the arrangement of elements in Mendeleev's periodic table? Mendeleev just arranged all the elements which were present at that time in such a way that he just arranged that elements in increasing order of atomic masses, and he just took care that the elements having similar properties directly come under one another. Means he just arranged the elements in such a way that all the elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic masses, and elements having same properties, same chemical properties, come directly under one another, means in a same group. And for that he just kept some vacant places in his periodic table. So what are the merits, what are the characteristics, what are the special characteristics of Mendeleev's periodic table? Mendeleev was the first scientist who successfully classified all the elements which were present at that time. So at the time of Mendeleev, there were 63 elements present, and he just successfully classified all that 63 elements in his periodic table. So he was the first scientist who successfully classified all 63 elements which were present at that time. This is the most important characteristic of Mendeleev's periodic table. Then second merit of Mendeleev's periodic table is he just kept some vacant places for the elements which were not discovered at that time. This is the most important property of Mendeleev's periodic table. He just kept vacant places, some vacant gap, places, some gaps in his periodic table for the elements which were not discovered at that time. And also he predicted, characteristics of the elements which were not discovered at that time. And students, in reality, what will happen? Exactly the same elements, we will find that elements, and that elements were placed into that gaps. So he just predict properties of elements that had not been discovered at that time. Means in Mendeleev's periodic table, I will explain this by giving example. He just kept vacant place and named there Ica aluminium. And later on, we just find that element gallium, which just exactly fit into the table in the position of Ica aluminium. So Ica aluminium is nothing but gallium. Ica boron means scandium, and Ica silicon means germanium. Means he just kept vacant places for the elements which were not found at that time. And in reality, we will get that element after some years, and then that element just exactly fitted into that places. When one more important merit of Mendeleev's periodic table is, when noble gases like helium, neon, argon were discovered, they could be placed in a new group without disturbing Mendeleev's periodic table. So students, we were just using Mendeleev's periodic table for many years, because that table was had lot of merits with them. That's why we were using that table for many years. But what are the demerits? Though Mendeleev's periodic tables have these much merits, why we are not using Mendeleev's periodic table nowadays? Because Mendeleev's periodic table also have some limitations, some demerits that we will discuss in our next video lecture. So students, today we have discussed about Euler's octave, examples of Euler's octave, what are the merits and limitations of Euler's octaves, and also we have discussed about what is mean by periodic table, what is mean by periods, groups, what is Mendeleev's periodic table, means how, what is the law of Mendeleev's periodic table, and what are the merits of Mendeleev's periodic table. Again, I will revise merits of Mendeleev's periodic table. Mendeleev was the first scientist who successfully classified all the 63 elements which were present at that time. Also, he kept vacant places for elements which were not discovered at that time. Along with these vacant places, he just predicted properties of elements that had been not discovered at that time. And in reality also, we found that elements which fitted into the position, like Ica aluminium means gallium, Ica boron means scandium, and then Ica silicon means germanium. And last, when noble gases were discovered, we just easily put that noble gases into Mendeleev's periodic table without disturbing the table. he just kept means we just displaced that noble gases in a new group without disturbing the original table. These all are the merits of Mendeley's periodic table. Then tomorrow we will discuss about demerits, limitations of Mendeley's periodic table. I hope you got all points related to Newland's octave and Mendeley's periodic table and its merits. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.